What is going on, everybody? Welcome to the G Show. Welcome to Wednesday. Happy Wednesday to all of you. We're just in part two. We're gonna go into part two of the Facebook groups out of three. So thanks you for being here. My name is Gordon Attard. If this is your first time, from gordonattard.com, and excited to have you here. Let me know in the comments below where you're coming from, and watch us as well. And we'll get started shortly. So a couple of things before I get started. Number one is, if you're watching this and you haven't watched part one, I highly suggest you to do that after, perhaps, so you don't get distracted, because we literally, I just shared with you some stuff in last week's episode, where I talked about the importance of having Facebook groups. And if you're into getting set up perhaps your Facebook group for allowing more prospects, or allowing people who you meet on a daily basis to check out your product, to check out what you're doing, check out what is your opportunity perhaps, I highly suggest you to go and watch back part one of this three-part series sort of thing. So today's episode, as I said, I'm gonna talk about what to post, okay? What type of content you should post. So let's get into it right away. So kudos to you who are watching us from all around the world. I see you popping in, and share this around if you find value as well. You're helping me that way as well. And text someone who maybe asked you about Facebook groups and you didn't have an answer. And I guess this can help them sort their group out. So we're gonna talk about groups, not groups that already exist. These are groups that you need to create, as I said earlier last week, actually. So you need to really focus on two things. Either you're gonna do a group for just customers only, you can do also a group that you're gonna focus on the business side as well. So you can do both. You can set them out, have a system and set them out, which I will share with you in just a second here. And then you need to put and pour content in there. People need to see you. Okay, not your sponsor, not your upline, okay, but they need to see you. Okay, this is the famous say, people will always join you, okay, not what you do. So very important, this is gonna help you, that the same as helping me and people in my team who have groups, created groups that introduces the opportunity and especially the products, so they can get the hold and understand. And also, as I said, is the timing. You don't know the timing of the people who are watching. We're bombarded to use the microwave kind of decision making, but it's not like that. Different timings, people join in different timing as well. So let's get into the content. So kind of post. So the first thing that you really need to set up is your cover, your Facebook cover. And I highly suggest you to put in the name of the group in the Facebook cover. That's the number one thing that you need to do. And say what it is. It's just like a YouTube channel, or maybe any type of cover, like cover book. Okay, it tells what it is on the tin. So the same thing on the Facebook group cover. You need to say what it is and what is that they're gonna learn. So if it's health and wellness, you mentioned this is a health and wellness Facebook private group. If you're focusing on something else like travel, mention travel and lifestyle Facebook group, etc., etc. Okay, you got the point. If it's real estate, the same thing. Okay, you're showing people how to purchase perhaps real estate, whatever it is the case. So that's number one thing. And in the cover, another thing that you should, in my opinion, you should add is an indication, like a guideline, what they must see first. So I fancy to do, and I do all my covers nowadays, not just with Photoshop, but very easy on canva.com. Probably you've heard it before. Okay, you can go and check it out. You can do it on your phone, guys. You can download the Canva app, or you can go on www.canva.com. And you can do an indication next to the title and the subtitle of the Facebook cover, watch the pinned post. Okay, so you're indicating people. So if it's a video that you're putting, or if it's a message that you recorded, tell them in the Facebook cover. So why? Because as soon as they get in, maybe you accept them because it's a private group, they see, okay, first thing they see is the cover. So guide them what to do first. It's like kids, they don't know, you know, it's like you entering in a restaurant and there's no host at the entrance. Nobody told you, it's like, where should I go? Right? Should I go and sit down here? You know, it's the same thing. So welcome them the right way. And the pinned post is very, very important because they start to understand what it is the group is all about. Okay, they're not gonna go and click the about section. Most people, they just watch the first post. That's why it's called pinned post. So what you need to do is you need to set it up. You need to set up then the pinned post. And the pinned post, you just write a post saying like, welcome to this group. Okay, let's say welcome to the Joe's Health and Wellness group. And then you tell them what they're gonna find in the group. So I share updates, I share giveaways, promotions, okay? So you, basically what you're going to say in a text, in a form of text, or you can do a video, okay? Video is very powerful in a pinned post because they see you, okay? They see you telling them what they are gonna learn more about in this group. So you can write some points out, you can record a video using your phone, and then you can upload it there. And if you have some files, for example, people that want to download certain things, maybe you have a checklist that you want to give out for free, or maybe testimonials, you can put them in the file section and add them in the pinned post, in the text, okay? Let them know about that. So they know where they can find maybe what people are saying about the products or opportunity that you're presenting in that group. And also how to download your checklist, perhaps their first thing, second thing, third thing they need to do when they get the product, or how to use it. You know, some products like for example, for skincare, et cetera, how to apply it the best, et cetera. Okay, you got the feel. Right? So this is a very, very important thing that, in my opinion, that's why I dedicated some time in here about the pinned post. Now, the other thing is, on weekly, when it comes to weekly, what kind of posts should you post? So Facebook Lives is highly important, number one thing. So try to go live at least once or twice a week. Okay, you're not gonna spend hours and hours in there if you don't have that kind of time. But again, what I suggest you to do is pretty simple. Go live there. You can go live with using a strategy that maybe highlight a product, number one thing, explain without even mentioning many things, but how that product can be applied, what are the benefits, okay, get into that. Other things that you can share, you can invite someone, or maybe you can pre-record an interview with someone who have used the products and they've got the benefit out of it. Pretty cool, right? So that's all about experiences. So share experiences. If, for example, maybe you're in travel and you have been, or maybe someone in your customer group went on a trip, had a blast, saved some money. So share that experience. You can share an image and write all the story. People love to read stories, especially in groups as well. And or maybe tell that person when they go on next trip to record the video so you can download it and use it in this group. It's all about that kind of value, that kind of content that you need to provide for people. Again, so when the time is right, they can ask you how to become customer or maybe partner up with you. So another kind of content is the how-tos. Again, how-tos, how to use this, how best to apply for that, how best to implement certain products or the services, okay? Where is the contact numbers and how maybe you experience something that you should tell everybody and you shared it there as well. Pretty awesome, so you're helping out as well. Promotions, so you can do promotions. So maybe there is a promotion in your company, that's one thing, but you can create a promotion, okay, giving out maybe a book or maybe some of the products, okay, couple of products away, by people taking action and join as customers or maybe partner up with you. So that's pretty awesome that you can do. So giveaways as well. Maybe you set up, maybe you're good and create content like I said, like checklists and stuff like that, that will help people, and you can share them with the people in the group as well in there. So another thing that I highly suggest you, a lot of people, when you do a video perhaps and you do the call to action to go maybe and private message you, they think they like, okay, I'm gonna message him maybe later on tonight or maybe tomorrow, and they forget. So the best thing, in my opinion, that you can apply, try it out, test it out, give it a run, is to use Google Forms. Okay, so you can go on Google Forms. It's very, very simple. You can create a form, okay? So like name and surname, email address or WhatsApp number or Instagram, whatever it is that is best for you and them to connect. And you create a form. So the cool thing about Google Forms, when someone fills out the form, you receive an email like a notification. So you're qualifying people, okay? For example, how you can use it, you can give content out on a Facebook Live and you can say, listen, the first five people who are gonna join as customers from today till the end of the month, which is like 4 or 5 days away, okay? This is what they're gonna get. This checklist, this free products, etc., etc., okay? But I'm looking for the first five. The reason being is I'm looking to help those five people and to give some time also away, like a one mentoring with them as well, how to use the products and how best they can get the benefit out of that. So what you need to do is to go, and I'm gonna give you in the first comment, I'm gonna post a form. You need to fill that out, okay? You need to fill that out. And the first five people that I see that they compiled the form, I'm gonna reach out to you and we jump on a call. And what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna give you a call, and this is how we can get you started. So this is the kind of thing you can do in groups. It works fantastic because you're separating those who take action from others, okay? So that's pretty much something that I highly suggest you to do as well. So then you reach out, okay? Reach out, you can do Q&As, some lives that you can do as well, interviewing people, maybe people who are customers, again, who you can add to the group, and or maybe you pre-record this and you put it there. And this is all about what it's all about. It's all about giving that content and be relentless on the type of content. And there's a lot of things that you can do, but if you provide the content, it's better because people, again, they're gonna see more you and they're gonna reach out to you even faster than you've ever thought. So I hope that this concludes part two of what type of posts and content you should provide on your Facebook groups. These are groups, again, either if it's for a customer group or maybe an opportunity that you're gonna share the opportunity with people that you talk to every single time. And when it comes to part three, okay, which is next week, so make sure you tune in next week. And again, if you haven't watched part one, go and watch it. You can find these episodes basically on my YouTube channel. You just search Gordon Attard on the YouTube channel, and there are a ton of videos as well. In fact, this is episode number 42. So in last part, okay, part number three, which is gonna be next week, about the Facebook groups, I'm gonna give you I'm gonna share with you some other secrets how you can grow now, okay, how we can grow your Facebook group so more people can know about the content that you're providing in there. And there's no resistance you're gonna add them there, and without spamming anyone or these sort of things, okay? So you are gonna continue to build relationship with those people. So having said that, that's all I have for you. Thanks for those who are tuning in, watching the live. If you're watching the replay, hashtag replay, leave a comment below. Let me know what you thought about this part three series of so far episode part two actually of this Facebook group part series. If you found value, share this around, click the share button, click the hearts button and the wow emojis as well. I love that as well. And I'll see you on next Wednesday for the G Show, for the last, this time for the last part of three. And there's ton of value, ton of more to come for you as well. So make sure if you're, this is your first time, make sure you follow and click on, turn on the notifications as well. That's all I have for you. Have a great rest of the Wednesday, my friends. It's a hump day, and wherever you're watching us, and take care. God bless. Bye-bye.